Hello everybody, my name is Walter, and today I want to show you how I can build my ultra-compact 2x2 aquarium door you can see here right in front of you. So this door was inspired by a recent video from Mambo Jumbo, where he designed such a door. And actually, this here uses a very similar piston and dispenser setup as he did, but a completely different philosophy behind the wiring, which allowed me to make this a much more compact design actually. But before we get to the sizes, let's show you this in action. So at the moment I have this receded 2x2 aquarium with some fish in there and a button. And if I press the button, after roughly 2 seconds, the fishes get transported upwards into the now flooded aquarium at the top. The aquarium at the bottom gets drained and opens up, so I now can just walk through here. And if I press the button again, the whole thing resets itself, which means that now I have aquarium at the bottom again, and the fish is in there. By the way, this whole thing here is completely safe, so I haven't managed to have those fishes here dying from being out of the water, or from actually getting not transported completely into the second upper aquarium there. So, a very safe design actually. Anyway, let's talk about the sizes. So as you can see, it's 3 blocks long, 8 blocks wide, and 8 blocks high. So a very, very compact design. This, by the way, is not part of the circuitry. It's just to relocate the button from down there to up here. And with that, let's get to the resources. So of course, you're gonna need some building blocks, then 2 soul sand blocks, 1 slime block, at least 1 immovable block, like obsidian or a furnace, for example. The second one is rather optional, actually. Then you're gonna need 4 stairs and at least 8 glass blocks for the bottom aquarium. If you have a top aquarium you want to look in, then you will have to double that. Then you're gonna need 2 redstone dust, 20 observers, 22 sticky pistons, 10 dispensers, 4 fence gates, or alternatively, if you want to make this a bit less noisy, you can replace those with hoppers. Then a wooden button. Make sure this is a wooden button. This thing here doesn't really work properly with a stone button. Then of course, water buckets. At least 1 water bucket for each dispenser. And then maybe some more, since the stairs will have to be waterlogged. And then of course the fish to put in there. And that's pretty much all you're gonna need, so let's now show you how to build this door here. Okay, so the first step is building a little structure right below the center of the door. With a 1 high gap you have the 2 soul sand blocks right at the center of the door essentially. Then towards the front and back you have 2x2 stairs upwards down with the opening facing inwards. Then next, below the stairs at the back, we place 2 full blocks to keep the water from spilling downwards. At the front we need just 1 block, which is also our input, so we can place for now our button there. Make sure this is a wooden button, by the way. Then we need a sticky piston right here, followed by a slime block and normal block. Then on top of the slime block, an immovable block and another one here. This is essentially just to keep the water from spilling out, and can usually also be left out, but I actually like it being there. So anyway, then on this side here we just need a sticky piston diagonal like that, followed by a normal block, no slime block this time, then normal block on top of the piston and on the side of this block. So now we have a more or less symmetrical structure. And from this point on, all of the following steps are mirrored from right to left, so I will show you how to build the right side, and then you just mirror this on the left. So for that, start with an observer right there, then you can place a block on top of that. Next we need an observer right here, followed by a sticky piston around the corner, like that. Then we need another observer facing upwards here, followed by a fence gate or a hopper, then another observer, fence gate, and observer. Then let's go and place a sticky piston here, followed by 2 sticky pistons to front and back, and another one right here. Then in this gap, we place a block with some redstone dust on top. Then we need two dispensers facing inwards like that. A full block on top of the soul sand. Then you can already grab some glass. So this is already part of the aquarium doors, essentially. Here we need a spit out block right there. Then another full block right here. On top of this observer, we need a full block with a sticky piston in this direction, then a spit out observer facing downwards with a sticky piston with a block right below it, like that. Then another observer right in this direction. Then we need a dispenser facing into this spit out block here. And another two dispensers diagonally like that. Then grab another observer, place it like that. A sticky piston in this direction with an observer facing towards the front like that. And then let's finally grab another sticky piston, place it facing downwards right here with an observer right below it facing into this block. And that's pretty much all of the circuitry. So let's now quickly mirror this. So with the wiring now finished, it's time to waterlock those four stairs here. Then put a water bucket in each of those four dispensers down here. And you can at this point also start putting water buckets in those two dispensers here. Then press the button once. And this thing here should close like so. Next step is then building the aquarium up here. So for that, place a few blocks there. Then you can use glass blocks here or you can use normal blocks, depending whether on you want to see the fishes up there. Then, well, actually, while you're at this point, you can already start filling in the fish inside of the water tank like so. Then, at this point, we can also put in the water buckets inside of the top dispensers. And then don't forget to actually close up the entire thing at the top. And then let's give it a try. And as you can see, the whole thing is now working and finished. So that's basically the point where it's time to start filling in the front and the back wall. And voila, so as you can see, I now fit in the front and back wall, prettied up the rest of the build a bit, and I also decided to replace this obsidian block here with a movable block, and the water spillage is simply stopped by another block right at the front here. And that's pretty much the entire thing in a nutshell. So as you can see, you can even see through this little window at the top the fissures when the door is opened. So this is also a little nice detail. And basically that was how you can build this ultra compact 2x2 aquarium door. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial and well, see ya!